god. Oh my god, what is this? Okay. Okay, that was spooky. Alright, what's gonna happen here?
Okay, and we are live. This is Master Morris here. Give me one sec to fix my audio. I was over at GlitchCat7's channel. There's a new Super Mario World ROM hack out called Invictus, designed by a person named JuzzCook on Twitch. I'm not sure if he's a streamer too, I believe he is, but he's semi-popular. Hey, Rascal. How are you doing? I'll be starting my game up here in a second. I'm just posting all my stuff to Facebook, Twitch, and stuff. Your sound is muted. There we go. Anyways, I'm starting up the game here in a second. Drink. There we go. Game started up. There we go. Game's up. Campaign menu. Back in the Age of Kings campaign, continuing with Barbarossa's Pope and Anti-Pope. This mission is a difficult one. But yeah, I have to convert this thing. Without, you know, blowing it up and other stuff, blowing other stuff up. For that, you kind of need a base to get started. Which means you're kind of forced to attack your neighbors. Not this neighbor though, this guy's a nice guy. Now, the neighbor I'm talking about is called Crema. Green. Crema. Crema. Cream cakes. I don't know what they're calling. They're over here, and they're a threat. So we'll be coming over here to their town and taking it. Give me one sec for this. Which one is it? Where is 12? There we go. Uh-oh. River guard's punching me. Just start converting their villagers. Stop that. Ah, run villagers, run! Run. Okay. Got some troops. Everybody's alive. Oh, a monk died and a couple soldiers died or something. I can't build it. We have a knight that is attacking people. What I want to do, convert all their units. I can use them to help me. I mostly want those archers because they're the most useful. That and villagers. And, can't get redemption without a market. Want redemptions, I can convert all their buildings to mine. Be a lot easier than making them. There's the villagers I've been looking for. These are not the droids you're looking for. These are the villagers you're looking for. I ran inside the building. How rude. I do have to make a town center, though. Need that. Thought I had a third monk. Oh, there he is. Looking for you. Very nice. Sorry that my throat clearing is probably pretty loud. There's a villager attacking my market. It's hilarious. Just entertaining. He's just whacking away at my market. They have a second market for some reason. What I'm gonna do is go convert their archery range. So you know, I have a market. An extra market. Ooh, villager. Free stone. Where'd I put my third monk? Oh, there he is. Oh, look, sheep. Taking a while to convert the buildings. I'll get there eventually. Thing is, they keep making villagers, so I'll keep getting free villagers, which is awesome. Really wish I knew why my throat gets so irritated for no reason. I'm thinking it's acid reflux. But nobody has any idea the actual cause. Convert all the buildings. It's except you can't convert the sound center. So you kind of have to blow it up. Seems like they've run out of food for the most part. Oh, wait. There's another villager. Let's freak the villager out a little bit. They ran inside, of course. Come out of the village now, please. Thank you. There we go. Hey, beat him. They completely resigned because they took other villagers. Oh, I forgot to check my ships. Apparently they survived, but barely. Yeah, the river guard's a big threat. Well, to me anyways. Doesn't seem like Karsino's very bothered by them. Taking all the farms as my own. You have a villager attack them, and it automatically converts them to yours. So we still need that building. Need these houses. It's nice that you don't even have to build your own town. You just literally convert an enemy's town to your own. And now I'm gonna have 3 markets. What use is that? There probably isn't one. You only really need 1 market. Maybe a backup. But like, I mean, I guess you can run trade caravans from each one to some other market, but problem with that is, and I have a very clogged trade route. The only thing I can think of is if I don't convert that one, I can run caravans from here up to there, and from here down to here. It'd be a little awkward with just a 2 gold gain. I think I'm just gonna convert it, have an extra, or actually convert it and delete my other 2 markets. In order to gain the most gold, or wait, hold on a second. Does yellow even have a market? Oh crap, they don't even have a market. Oh no, yes they do. What the heck? They do have a market, and it's just not directly visible. We're gonna delete these 2 markets. They have? What? Ow. Wait, that was Crema. So that was me taking everything of theirs and blowing some of the stuff up. Yeah. Crema's already gone. I might even just delete that market and make a new one. Monka S. Monk. Where's my monk? I don't know where my monk is. No idea. I still have a house up there to convert, or two, or something. Ooh, and a mining camp, interesting. Alright, and I believe that's it for Crema, however you want to pronounce her name. Start researching stuff. Got all my villagers on farms. Now I'll get those farms used up. All the buildings are converted. Go around and grab some relics and stuff. Anything else to scout, really? Have a gold mine. What are these allies for? They don't really do much. I don't think they attribute to you either. They're just sitting there. Whoa. Rip ship. Very much rip ship. Okay then. So I'm gonna need a navy. I'm gonna try to do convert the enemy navy. But the demolition ship tried to detonate, failed, then changed targets. That was weird. Like, it made the sound for it, but it didn't actually go through the full animation, so it canceled it. That was interesting. Oh. Didn't even realize I had this market earlier. I can just delete that one, too. Sweet, free ships. Who doesn't love free ships? Oh, I lost the monk. Are you kidding me? That's depressing. Okay, then. I got plenty of gold. Rip ships. Uh-oh. Getting attacked. Run, villagers, run. Apparently, River Guard will deploy troops to attack you. Couple of new docks. Have a bunch of monks. Probably gonna want a castle as well. Where did you guys come from? Rift troops. These three and these two are not getting rebuilt. They're just getting used up. Basically just have to build up a stable economy and then wipe the enemy out. What? Dang it, come on. Stop that. Come on, stop killing my monks. Seriously. What the heck? I want the bomber cannon. Really? Okay. Kill this bombard cannon. Oh man, I upgraded two-handed swordsman already. I'm still stuck in the castle age. I'm finally getting some good resources. Surprise stone is so cheap. So very, very cheap. I have a feeling I'm going to need more castles. Get rid of those more annoying farms. We're actually gonna make a few more castles to make for excellent defenses while I build up enough forces to storm the city and convert the thing. Hey, greetings, Balto. How are you doing? How you doing, Balto? Sorry if my replies may be like a couple minutes late in response to messages. I have to alt-tab between the game and chat to respond to them. I just wanted to give a heads up about that. Anyways, hey, Balto, welcome to the stream. Oh, crud. Crud, 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 crud. Villagers are getting eaten. That's not good. Doing all playing Skyrim. Oh, nice. Stormcloak playthrough. I need to get Skyrim again, probably for the computer. I used to have it for the Xbox 360, but my disc ended up breaking, and I never went and got a new one. I'd love to play it again. My favorite Elder Scrolls game is actually, and my favorite game of all time is Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion. And I really enjoy that, and I still have that for the Xbox. I actually have a backwards compatible version of the game that I use. These enemy troops really do not like me. Alright, let's make another castle. I'll hopefully deal with these guys. Lost both my knights. Both of them. Not one, but both. Usually do an Imperial playthrough. Have this. Okay. I can't exactly remember the storylines in Skyrim. Or what factions there are and whatnot. I just play as an Argonian, do a ton of side quests, and I actually really like doing all the Daedric quests. As one of my first objectives. Though some of them are level limited. these pikemen aren't of much use to me. Four castles later, and we still hope we have enough defenses. We probably don't. We can just keep finding new landing spots. Until I have the entire coast defended. Which we'll have defended soon enough. We have enough stone piles to do it. Don't really need these guys anymore. A lot of trade caravans need to get our upgrade. Upgrading our other stuff and other units. Almost have another castle. Don't need this. Buildings full. That's all the units I can make for now. Didn't see how they dropped off the units there. We almost have this entire coast lit up. Once we get all the stone mined, we'll have those villagers go mine a lot of gold. No, I'm not doing that stone back there. There's really no point. Interesting game. But yeah, Age of Empires 2 is pretty fun. It does take a bit of time to get through a lot of campaign missions. The regular multiplayer gameplay is a bit more fast-paced. Still, the games usually take about an hour to play, depending on how fast the players are moving and progressing. Competitive Age of Empires games are really where you want to watch people play. And this is the HD edition, so it's on Steam. It's a remade version of the original game, which was pretty much a Windows 7 game that people like to play. And it's in the real-time strategy category. It's probably by far the most popular of the real-time strategies. The other most popular ones being StarCraft, StarCraft 2, I think Warcraft is one, but I haven't played it, so I'm not sure if it was an RPG or if it was a strategy. And the other popular ones are the Warhammer 40,000 Dawn of War games, which are based on the board game. Well, not board game, the tabletop. I guess it's a board game, but it was a tabletop game that they designed. It's actually kind of expensive to get into, but the video games were really nice. And I actually played the Dawn of War series on my stream before, from first game up to the newest one, which is called Dawn of War 3. The series was a little weird on how it went with video games. It went Dawn of War, Dawn of War Winter Assault Expansion, then it went Dawn of War Dark Crusade, which was a separate game. Then it went Dawn of War Soulstorm, which was another separate game. And then after that, it went Dawn of War 2, then had a bunch of Dawn of War 2 expansions. Most common one, I think, was Retribution, which is the one I liked. And then it went, after all of those, the expansions, it went into Dawn of War 3. And then they also have a lot of other games based on the same universe. I kinda got a lot of lumber, so thinking I can just start making farmers. And I need some other buildings. Seems like everything's set up pretty well. Have these guys go mine gold that I need. Don't need that anymore. I don't need this anymore. Actually, I'll have these guys split up, one on one pile, one on the other. At Imperial Age, I can start researching everything. Not enough food, apparently. I have a ton of stone. Literally, I have 2,000 pounds of stone. See? Well, actually, a little over 2,000. Well. Apparently these guys will attack River Guard when they're around. Actually hoping to do was to get cannon galleons. I don't see gunpowder in the research list. I'm gonna make a few docks that I need. That guy's gonna construct a bunch of docks for me. Still got a lot of researches. Can I get cannon galleons as the Teutons? I can, apparently, but only regular ones. Get chemistry? Don't think I. Oh, apparently I already did chemistry as a research. Need more food. two docks up. Food and wood, of course. Trying to see what all modifiers it'll give for each one. Just one doesn't do anything. Hits two, it goes to five. These guys gathered all the forage bushes, now they'll be farmers. Wrong spot. I said 60 wood. I can buy some wood. That upgrade. Now I need more food. Can't win with this, can I? Ooh, castles have +3 range. Interesting. Of course, I need a lot more food, and food is the most expensive resource right now. What do these allies even do other than sit there and let be a trade port thing? That and be a distraction to some extent. Just a little bit more wood. Might cut down on gold miners a little. Another gold mine. Cut down on archers. A little bit of a waste of resources, but that's fine. The older campaigns only have a population limit of 75. The newer ones are all like 100 to 200, sometimes even 3. They're not as common. It's usually in around 200. Some of them are like 100, 125, and 150. None that I've seen that are 175 limit. If 5 cannon galleon should be enough. Crenellation's researching. A lot of food and gold. Don't need any of those researches. With crenellations comes really high range towers. Or high range castles. 13 range on my castles. Just barely out of range of killing the enemy castle. But my cannon galleons can hit it perfectly fine. Thing is, with this range, I could literally kill other Teutonic cannon galleons. So we're gonna slowly work our way over, taking out the river guard, all their castles and troops and whatnot, or at least paving a way that I can break into Milan. Five more cannon galleons should help. Should help a lot.
Barbarossa now commands a massive army. Stay alert, they should attempt to cross the river.
Yeah, I do command a massive navy. Thank you. I appreciate the compliments, enemy. Enemy castles. Frankish castles are extremely cheap and not very strong. They ran into my castle, sweet. decent amount of their resources, their army, etc. Let's make a path. Yeah, they could have made this ally a little more useful. The AI is not very helpful. Rip that tower. Poor cannon galleon took a hit because I got it too close. Oh well. Rip ship. Let it rip ship. Oh look, a bunch of enemy infantry. That can't really do anything to me. Currently seems that I've saved up a lot of resources, which is good. Once I'm done taking out all these towers, breaking a path into the base, I'll need those resources to field an army to go in. I have to protect several monks, getting them to the cathedral. Oh, like a silly little mangonel coming to attack me. Let's need a good sized hole. Good sized hole. Just put a dent in the wall. I just thought of a good meme. You can tell how angry a guy is by the size of a hole he puts into a wall. Giant hole inside of a wall on Age of Empires. I'm gonna make an Age of Empires meme. Thank you. Rip ship. Rip Mega now, rip ship. Don't mind me, just clearing a path. Sweet, I can't hit the barracks. Okay. Now I need a transport ship. Should make it two. Monks and my archers, and I need to delete my cannon galleons when they're done blowing stuff up. Poor villagers. You know what? Let's make a slightly bigger hole. Make a gate bigger than the gaping dragon of Dark Souls. Make a gap. Yeah, there's a gaping hole in the wall. Wonder where that came from. Six. So I can create four monks in total. That guy can be deleted. I'll make one more transport. Make some more archers. Or, better yet, and Teutonic Knights should help tank. We can get enough gold. Let's see where all the enemies are. And probably get enough gold. Meanwhile, in selling all our resources land, I still don't have enough resources. How do we got enough space for units? Okay, one monk. 10 Teutonic Knights. All my researches. And so we have this crew ready. We should be good to go. Seems like the only way I'll be getting that is if I wait a while or I kill a bunch of villagers. I really don't want to bother with either. Last month research. Goes as close as possible. Properly. Oh, come on, stop hitting my monks of all things, please. Why are my units can't path properly? Stop hitting my monks. Please stop hitting my monks. I hit all my monks. All but one of my monks are dead. And all my monks are dead already. Dang it. Alright, try this again. Instead. Ten monks. Ten hand cannoneers. Oh, let's make another transport ship. These ones are fine. These ones will build this and then get killed off. This one's getting killed off. Oops, I forgot. I need to do the upgrades too. Hopefully this will work a lot better. Having a mixture of units that defend my monks. too ready to go. Hand cannoners, cavaliers, and monks are close to being ready to go. Three. Make another second. Five ships now, 50 units. Let's do this. I can recreate one villager. These ships get here, we'll do a quick save just in case something really screwy happens, like a mega now killing all my monks in a couple hits or a hit or something like that. Probably something regarding a mega now, but we'll figure it out. Okay, ships are just up here. Save. MARC, come on. Loading. There we go. Oh. They have a lot of villagers. Leave my monks alone. Oh my god, they killed all my monks again. These little annoying hand cannoners, they just don't die. I think I just loaded a replay, not a save file. Oops. Try this again. Mars. AoE 2. Load. Loading game. Oh, the manga now, really? Go after the hand cannoniers, please. Finally got it. We are in there. Second time's a charm. Well, third time's a charm, actually, because that was the third try. Beautiful. We are victorious. Enemies defeated. Map is revealed. Look at all this empty space that nobody was using. So much wood. Finally. Add annoying missions out of the way.
Barbarossa was not kind to the Milanese. In response to voluntary negotiations during the siege, he sent 6 Italians marching back to the city. 5 had been blinded, but the 6th only had his nose cut off so that he could lead the other 5. Northern Italy had been mercilessly conquered and placed under imperial governance, but Italy would not submit. If anything, the destruction of Milan made the Italian cities even more incensed at their would-be emperor.
We are not liking Barbarossa. The Lombard League.
As long as Barbarossa's knights were present, peace endured. But the Emperor could not be everywhere at once. Whenever he went to Italy, Germany would flare up. When Barbarossa returned to Germany, the Italians began plotting again. Milan had fallen, but the remainder of the Italian cities joined together in a confederation known as the Lombard League for the purpose of defeating Barbarossa. If Barbarossa continued to be Italy, part of the Holy Roman Empire, he would have to conquer the Lombard League city by city. But Barbarossa still had a secret weapon. Henry the Lion and his seasoned troops.
A new challenger enters the fray. Henry the Lion appears.
Thank you.
Get my guys. Get the heck out. Pretty much all I can do there.
Now we will be forced to rebuild our forces before we can conquer Italy.
Annoyingly, yes, but... the way up here. And hopefully not getting destroyed by those bomber... Oh my god. Can we stop going to the west? Just head straight. I lose a freaking ship. I can't tell. On to the next mission. We're doing alright so far. Let's kill that guy yet. Sheesh, taking more forever to kill him. Okay, here's one that I can do. It's Padua. There are what? Two entrances in, I think? Crap. This guy's getting attacked. Get out of here, Venice. Nobody likes you. Thank you for dying. Okay. Start building some houses. Good there. That scout ship. Get out of here, you silly little fire ships. You got nothing on me. There's no passage back here, so basically, we just block off from here to here. They can't get.